But for all of us to enjoy God's intervention this month, what do we need? One, genuinely repent from sin and ask God for forgiveness. Genuinely repent from your sin and ask God for forgiveness. We cannot cover that up. The Bible says we can't continue in sin and say that grace should abound. Let all of us repent and let's make a U-turn. I'm begging by the mercy of God, repent, not because of the church, not because of your husband, your wife, or anybody, for your own destiny's sake. If you really want God in your life to show up, repent from sin and ask for forgiveness. Number two, choose to be obedient to divine instructions. From time to time, instructions have been coming and will continue to come. Obey them. Obey God's word. Obey God's instruction. There is no big man or big woman in the house of God. I'm a pope, I'm an archbishop. It doesn't make any meaning to God. We must obey him. He's our creator. Obey instructions. Number three, let us cry to him for intervention. Throughout this month, cry to God on daily basis for intervention. Cry to God for intervention. Cry to God for intervention. Cry to God for intervention. Number five, let's give ourselves to kingdom service. That's one of the things that bring intervention, kingdom service. Consciously make up your mind to serve the Lord. Make up your mind to serve your Lord, to the Lord. Serve in the house of God. Serve outside. Serve on the road. In your own way, find a way of doing something for the Lord. Serve the Lord. Serve God with your time. Serve God with your money. Serve God with whatever you have. Anything you can use to serve the Lord, serve the Lord. Those are the things that bring interventions. Number five, be faithful to God in everything. Be faithful. Let nothing change that. Man may not be there, but God is there. Be faithful. Be faithful to your partners. Be faithful to the church. Be faithful to your parents. Be faithful in the area of your tithe, in your offering. That is not because of anybody. Since the day you have not been paying tithe, what can you show? I'll tell you one thing about the devil. I will tell you one thing about the devil. What you are not ready to give to God, he knows how to collect it from your hand. That's one thing you don't know about him. Satan, he's a bad devil. What you are not ready to give to God, he knows how to collect it. Early this morning, my branch pastor was with me and I was talking. I was asking them about some reports. And I said to them, please, that report you get to my office later by tomorrow. I mean, I said, you may not know it, but let me just tell you in case you do not know. We also give reports. We also do what? This church give reports. You don't know. The Venue Bible Church pay tithe. I'm not talking on me now. The ministry pay tithe. You think I'm a stupid pastor? Well, I'm not crazy. I pay my own tithe. The ministry pay tithe. Why? For the grace and covering over our head. You stand alone, everything happens to you all alone. Praise the Lord. Life doesn't work that way. If you are too selfish, you only consider yourself, you are just not wise, you will need authority and power one day. So as I pay, the ministry is paying. So I said, by tomorrow, you must get to me. And you understand what I mean? Because I also report that this means pay tithe. That's why there are some things that can never happen. No matter what, the grace will work. What will work? I share with you mystery. I'm sharing with you some of my secret. The grace will work. Even when I have no strength, the grace of the fathers will work. Am I talking to anybody here? Every time you connect yourself to me, I connect myself to them. I'm just telling you the old mystery now you don't know. You connect to me, I connect to them. I'm not stupid. I'm so smart. I know what I'm doing. And that one I've been from day one, not just now, from day one of the house of the ministry. I speak over your head. As you are faithful, you will enjoy intervention. So all of us who have not been tighter, please change you. Not for me, it's for your own destiny. Devil is a bad devil. Don't allow him to cheat you. Just 1 minute, he collects all the time for 10 years. That's what he does. And he do his diverse, all kind of things he uses. Scammer, deceiver, crooks, accident, loss. That's what he does. So don't allow him. Be wise. Beat him to it. He will not be a victim again. Number six, let's give ourselves to fasting and prayer. Very, very important. Give ourselves to fasting and prayer. And finally, number seven, let us take our work serious. Take your business serious. Take your work serious. Those of us who are students, take your studies serious. Take your career serious. Anything you do, take it serious. Be good at it. Your work, your business, your job, be good at it. Don't joke with your work. Don't joke with your business. Don't joke with your studies. Everybody be serious with whatever you do. If God will intervene, you must also be doing something. Everyone that enjoyed intervention in the scripture, I saw that they are also doing something. They are committed. Joseph now to interpret him, and he was good at his dream. Joseph signed the house of Potiphar. All of them are good at their work. So whatever be your job, be serious. I want to appeal today to every one of us who are businessmen, businesswomen, be serious with your business. You have a shop somewhere, be serious with your shop. Up to 12 noon, 11 a.m., 10 a.m., you are just tying up walking around the house. When your mates open their shops since 8 o'clock, what are you doing at home? It's a different thing. You have some business you are doing at home, you have your children you want to take care of. That's a different thing. But minus that, just hanging around, loafing about, what for? Go to your work. Go to your what? Talk to me now. Go to your work. Go to your place of work. And please, all of us who have job, who have business, be good at your work. Be what? If you tell somebody you are using a blade, use that blade. Don't tell someone you want to use a button that costs 50,000, that costs 1,000, and now you now go and use a button that costs 5 naira. You are spoiling your work yourself. Should I be blunt with you? I give you a business, I give you a job. You use bad material when you collect good money. I won't give you another one, even if you are a member of my church. Call it anything you like, that's your ethic. I won't give you another job. I don't add sentiment to that. That is not Christianity. If you collect the money, I'm using this body to work for you. I want to use this break. I want to use it, whatever to do, whatever it is. How much is 1,000 naira? Buy the of that value. Am I talking to anybody here? And I want to appeal to some of us also who are businessmen here. Please, who are doing work, whatever, be truthful. Why will you go to somebody, I want to do business for you? How much? You say, well, this is it. I want you to make it for me or buy it for me. How much is it? And you say to the fellow, it's 500 naira. It's 10,000 naira. So, what is your service? What is your charge? Well, for me to get this thing for you, I'm charging you 3,000 naira. That's my own labor. That's okay. I'm paying you the 3,000 for your charge. Now you collect 10,000 for this, and this thing is just 5,000 naira. If I find out tomorrow, I won't give you another job. Nobody is talking now. Do you hear what I'm saying now? Once you have collected your service charge, I'm charging you theater for doing this for you, that is it. Tell me this in five is 5,000 naira. If I find out tomorrow, I won't give you another one. That means you are not truthful. Sometimes it is not devil. Sometimes we, like we don't know what we are doing. So let's change. Be serious with your work. Be serious with your business. You get to a place of work or business and you are sleeping. 12 o'clock you are asleep and your boss come, correct you today. Another day correct you. You say the boss doesn't like you. It's not that the boss doesn't like you. You don't like yourself. Your place of work is not a sleeping place. Students, face your studies. Don't spend time on social media doing nothing. There's time for everything. And like I always talk to our young girls, once you are still in school, forget about boys. Forget about boys. Boys have sweet mouth. Don't let them sweet talk you. And the boys also focus on your studies. If you don't succeed as a boy, eventually you won't find a good lady. Ladies and gentlemen, whatever be your calling, your profession, whatever be your assignment, be serious as it. The summary today is this. There's no matter, problem, issue, that God cannot intervene. And when God intervenes, there will be a way out. Rise on your feet.